What's up, gang? Kids Kicks Contest and Mattress Fly Why. We successfully blew the Don issue 1, so now we'll tell you about the Don issue 2. Let's go! The first problems you will face with when buying the Don issue 2 is the choice of size. Shoes are small sized, and you should try them on before you buy them. It's great that Adidas has such an opportunity and sneakers can always be tried on before buying. Also, Don issue 2 are not suitable for players with wide foot, but those who have a high-end step will be satisfied. If you choose the right size and get under these conditions, then no time to get used to them is required and overall comfort is good. Padding here is everywhere throughout the shoe. In the heel it's without any structure, just thick layer. So the shoe don't allow air to pass through and you shouldn't count on ventilation. Mitchel foam bounce is responsible for cushioning in the Don issue 2. The structure is good here. The back part of the shoe is quite good at cushioning when you land on the heel. There is certainly not enough foam in the forefoot, but I can't say that it's critical if you play indoor or on a soft rubber surface. By the way, D-Rose 773 had bounce too, and it again proves that the word bounce has little meaning. The main thing is the density of the foam, which may or may not cover certain tasks, for example a comfortable landing on the heel. Since we are dealing with Spider-Man, we can see a web traction pattern. Also on the side there is an icy sole pedal for improved side traction. Basically, shoes do not slide, especially on asphalt and rubber. But on a dusty court they can slide, and not even on slide loads, but at the first step. But the set of materials is not allowed for signature shoes. Everything is very budgetary. There are no interesting things and cool inserts. In my opinion, in design they are worse than the first pair. They look like another no-name shoes from Adidas. Quality of build is good. In terms of durability they are good too. After the brutal, almost hellish tests that they went through in Sochi, the shoes look quite acceptable and nothing falls off. These lace loops are the only fear I have about these shoes. They are not credible at all. Leave a comment in the comment section below if they suddenly broke on someone's Don issue 2 or D-Rose 773. The forefoot is firmly fixed, so players with a wide foot will feel uncomfortable. I talked about it at the beginning. But to fix the heel you have to try hard. The fact is that the last loops is somehow located at the wrong angle and does not particularly press the foot to the heel and to the shoe. And if you do not do your best when tightening the laces, the foot will dangle and is fraught with injury. The problem is solvable. The main thing is to tight the shoes very much. Since laces don't troop the foot, there is won't be difficult. There is not side outrigger from the outside, but there is the outrigger from the inside, so the Don issue 2 are quite stable. Adidas issue 2 are suitable for amateurs and semi-pros. All points are at an average level, without any failures. They match their price, but don't exactly match the status of NBA star signature shoe. It was Kids Contest, Mattress Fly White. Subscribe to our channel and to our Instagram. It's very hot here. Mountains, air, and of course... Привет-привет, Sun Kicks Contest. Привет-привет.
Нет, это не то. Лёха, это не то приветствие.
В смысле?
Ну, типа, ты просто так сидишь. Это не то приветствие. Это сейчас не в моде.
Не в моде?
Не, точно нет. Не в этом году.